Last year, at the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania, Triple H and Randy Orton squared off for the WWE Championship, ending what was a brutal and deeply personal rivalry.
Now, you know, Jack, this year both men face equally brutal and personal challenges. Now, Triple H isn't called the Cerebral Assassin for nothing. He's a 12-time world champion, and he's made his name by defeating his opponents on the grandest stage of them all, elevating his game to its highest point at a time when the lights shine brightest.
Triple H knows how to perform when the lights shine. And this year, Triple H faces a man looking to do just that at the game's expense, the Celtic Warrior Sheamus. There's perhaps no superstar in history who's had a better first year in the WWE than Sheamus. And what a better way to cap off a stunning rookie year than by taking down the King of Kings at WrestleMania.
And perhaps no superstar with less of a tan, by the way.
I agree.
You know, just like Triple H will be dealing with a rising star in the form of Sheamus, Randy Orton will have his hands full with two of the brightest young stars in the WWE in a triple threat match with Cody Rhodes and Ted DiBiase.
It simply does not get any more personal than the relationship between these three men. The Viper taught Rhodes and DiBiase everything they know. Orton was their leader for more than 15 months, and at WrestleMania, it will be time to see if the students have surpassed their teacher.
I'll tell you what, Jack, I think Orton losing to his students could be a nightmare of Freddy Kruegerian proportions for the Viper. Mark my words on that. This past week on Raw, all five of these men were in the ring at the same time as former rivals Triple H and Randy Orton teamed up in a 3-on-2 handicap match to take on Sheamus and his tag team partner's Legacy.
Oh, and a triple threat matchup between Orton and Legacy set for Sunday at WrestleMania. A one-on-one matchup between Triple H and Sheamus set for Sunday.
Well, this a little different here, being a 3-on-2 handicap match. But you know the excitement and the tension that is just emanating from all the WWE superstars that are going to be a part of WrestleMania this Sunday. It fills the air here. That's just, it's inside this entire arena with over 13,000 fans. Ooh.
Already tonight, John Morrison defeated The Miz in a little preview match before WrestleMania. Kofi Kingston qualified for the Money in the Bank ladder match. Look at Cody Rhodes with a big right hand to Triple H.
Well, you know what? That's a veteran move right there.
Whoa! Spinebuster.
That is too.
And still to come tonight, Shawn Michaels takes on Kane. And the only way to win that matchup, much like Michaels faces versus The Undertaker Sunday, is via pinfall or submission. We know Bret Hart is here tonight. And we know Cena and Batista have their final face-off before WrestleMania.
Here we go! Whoa!
Ah, scoop slammer!
You can tell that Randy Orton has been waiting for this opportunity to deal out a little more physical abuse.
Randy Orton is ready for WrestleMania.
Whoa!
The Viper.
He can barely control himself. He's about to explode.
Coiled, ready to strike.
Watch it!
Cody Rhodes in trouble! Sheamus!
Oh. Huge boot to the side of Orton's head and
Sheamus takes advantage! Orton, the victim of the numbers game!
The team of Cody Rhodes, Ted DiBiase, and Sheamus!
Randy Orton could be in trouble heading into WrestleMania, King, because it looks like the numbers are going to be against him as well come Sunday in the triple threat match versus Rhodes and DiBiase.
And Rhodes and DiBiase are not over here rolling Triple H into the ring and instructing Sheamus to do the same thing that he just did to Randy Orton. And
Sheamus wants to take Triple H's head off.
Missed him! He missed him!
In the game! Triple H! Makes a stand.
Well, that makes you feel a little bit better about what it's going to be like when it's one-on-one. Hey, Sheamus wants a little more. Or maybe he doesn't.
But will it be Triple H's final stand as he heads into his matchup Sunday against the upstart Sheamus at WrestleMania?
There is no doubt that the Celtic Warrior Sheamus is a powerhouse and more than a formidable challenge for anyone in the WWE. But Triple H is a 12-time world champion and lives to perform at WrestleMania. The Game has made a career out of outthinking and outperforming his opponents when it matters most. Can the Irishman take down the King of Kings, or will the Cerebral Assassin be too much?
And what'll happen when it's every man for himself as Randy Orton, Cody Rhodes, and Ted DiBiase meet in a triple threat match at WrestleMania? Will the two students be able to work together and take out their former master, or will ambition get the better of them? After all, in a triple threat match, it's every man for himself.